Welcome to this video tutorial, one of many in a series designed to get you up and running with Leapfrog. This video is part 2 of 2 discussing importing and viewing 2D surface data. In this video, I'm going to cover importing and viewing GIS data, 2D grids, and points. In part 1, I left off with a project that contained a topography surface and a registered map. Now I'm going to discuss importing and viewing GIS data. Various types of GIS data can be imported into Leapfrog. To import, simply right-click the GIS Data, Maps, and Photos folder. There is a batch import option at the bottom, using which we can batch import files via map info XML file or an Esri geodatabase. However, if you're not batch importing, you'll select Import Vector Data. We can import shapefiles or map info tab files. You can multi-select different types of GIS data for import. By default, the filter data checkbox will be selected. By leaving this selected, elevation data will be removed and the GIS data will be filtered to within the bounding box selected. The bounding box can be made from any boundary in the project. By unticking the filter data checkbox, the data will be imported in its raw format. This will include all elevation data and will not be clipped by the boundary selected. In this example, we will leave the filter data checkbox ticked, so the elevation data will be lost and the data will be filtered to the edge of the bounding box. This warning box will appear and will allow you to either confirm or change your choice. I'll drag the river center lines file into the scene to view it. You'll see that the GIS data lines are sitting at an elevation of 0, so we will need to drape them on the topography surface in a similar manner to the maps that we've already looked at. To do this, we will come into our view and we will select Edit Views. You'll notice the two GIS lines that we've just imported are now available as a layer we can add to the map. If I select the river center lines and select Add, we'll move it over to the current layers. We will then need to move the GIS line above the maps to be able to actually see them. From here, we can also select to edit the color of the rivers, as well as the width. If we'd like, we can also adjust the transparency. I will now add the trails GIS lines and move them up the list so they too can be viewed. Once I've selected everything I'd like in the view, I can click Close. Also, now that my rivers exist on the topographic surface, I can remove them from the scene list. The next data I'm going to talk about is 2D grids. These can also be introduced into the GIS Data, Maps, and Photos folder. In this tutorial, I will import 2D grids representing the slope and aspect of the topography surface which has been previously imported. A number of different 2D grid formats are available for import. In this example, I will use an image file. As we can see, this image has already been georeferenced, so I can simply click OK. I will now import our second 2D grid. I'm going to now clear the screen so that I can see one of the 2D grids I've just imported. By default, the 2D grid is displayed using a color map based on the range of the data in the file. As you can see, we haven't set the elevation yet, so the grid is flat. To give the grid an elevation, right-click on the grid in the project tree and select Set Elevation. As we already have a topography surface in the project, we can select From Surface and use that topography surface. Click OK and the 2D grid will be displayed as the grid draped over the topography. We can repeat that process for the second grid. The last topic I will cover in this video is importing point data. Unlike the 2D GIS data we've been working with so far, the point data contains elevation information. Unless your point data exists as a shapefile, you will import the data into the points folder. The ideal format for points data is a CSV file that contains the XYZ coordinates and any relevant category or numeric data. To import the points, right-click the Points folder, Import Points. Select the points file of interest and click Open. You'll notice that the X, Y, Z columns have already been identified by Leapfrog based on the column headers. And in this case, I also wish to import the elevation column as numeric data. If I drag that information into the scene along with the topography, I can see those points represent the mountaintops. You should now have all the skills necessary for creating a topographic surface from an elevation grid, importing and viewing 2D GIS data, maps, and photos, as well as point data.